In this example, we'll look at calculations for a recycle reactor. So we have a plug flow reactor, volume V, and into the system we have a feed of reactant A, concentration CA0, and a volumetric flow rate V. We also recycle the same volumetric flow rate so that the volumetric flow rate going into the plug flow reactor is 2V, and we're mixing the outlet with the inlet, so this concentration is the average of the two, CA1, and the concentration leaving the reactor here, of course, is the same as the concentration here, same as the concentration here. This overall system has a conversion of 2/3. 2A goes to 2R is the reaction, it's second order. And the question is, suppose we shut off this recycle, then what happens to the conversion? So what we're going to do is write a mass balance for the plug flow reactor first. And for a plug flow reactor, the change in the molar flow rate of A, so FA is the volumetric flow rate in the reactor, which is 2V, concentration CA1, that's for entering, so that's into the reactor. The change in this flow rate respect to the cumulative volume is the rate of reaction, R sub A, which in the problem statement is given as minus K CA squared. So the stoichiometric coefficient in this case is built into the rate constant. It's a liquid phase system, so the volumetric flow rate's a constant, so I can write this as 2 times the volumetric flow rate, the change in the concentration with respect to volume. And so we can rearrange separate variables, the change in the concentration of A over CA squared is equal to minus the rate constant times dV over 2 times the volumetric flow rate. We integrate from the inlet reactor where the volume is 0 until the total volume V. The inlet of the reactor CA1, the outlet in our notation, the figure is CA final. So this integration just gives us minus 1 over CA evaluated between the limits. And the right side, rate constant's a constant, it's isothermal. The volumetric flow rate's a constant, liquid phase, V minus 0. So we can substitute in the limits, minus 1 over CA final plus 1 over CA1 equals minus K times V over 2 times the volumetric flow rate. And so now what we want to do is do a balance around this point. So we can calculate CA1 as CA0 plus CA final divided by 2. Right, we're mixing two streams with the same volumetric flow rate, and so we have CA1 now in terms of CA0. If X is 2/3, then CA final is 1/3 of CA0. So CA0, this is 1/3 CA0 divided by 2. So we now have CA1 in terms of CA0. We can go back to our mass balance and substitute in for CA final and CA1. And with that substitution, we can essentially just rearrange the equation and K times the reactor volume times CA0 over the volumetric flow rate is equal to 3. So these are going to be the same numbers now if we turn off the recycle. And so we're going to do a mass balance again, but with a different feed. And so what we're going to do is apply the plug flow reactor equation, second order again. Now the difference, one difference is that the volumetric flow rate is V instead of 2V. When there was recycle, it was 2V. It's only V now. We do the exact same integration, and we are trying to solve for CA2, and so minus 1 over CA2 is equal to minus 1 over CA0, and then KV over V is 3 over CA0. So it's minus 4 over CA0. Or CA2 is 1/4 of CA0. Which means the conversion of A now in the new system is 0.75. So this is with no recycle. With recycle, the conversion was 0.667. So we can check if this is what our expectations would be. When we have recycle, then we're diluting our feed to a lower concentration before it enters the reactor, so that lowers the rate. We're also increasing our volumetric flow rate, so it's less time in the reactor. So we expect less conversion with the recycle than without the recycle, and indeed that's what we see.